Hello. So we received interview questions from Soledad, who works at Las Deco magazine, which is a Chilean design, architecture, and art decoration magazine distributed around the country there. And we decided we'll respond to his questions via video.
Yeah.
So.
Because we're lazy. No. Because this is more natural.
Yeah. So the first asked a bit about our own backgrounds. Mm-hmm. My name is Hannah.
My name is Mika.
I studied industrial design and then media technology.
And I studied graphic design a long time ago. And then I studied art and technology study.
Yeah. And we met 10 years ago at the Art University in Austria and started collaborating. Mm-hmm. And next question is, how do we create Pobacam? So as a year or two after we started collaborating, mm-hmm. we decided we needed a website, and so we
needed a name.
We did a name for the domain,
yeah.
And which also got us thinking about what is our collaboration about. Mm-hmm. And Kobakant is two words. Koba comes from the Japanese and means
Koba is a factory in city and usually run by family, and they make, I don't know, from skirts to towels to shoes. Yeah, small factory.
Yep. And Kant is the German ending meaning someone who would work in such a place. So we're the people who work in these small family-run businesses. And what project are we currently working on? So we are sitting in the middle of our current project, which is a tailor shop for electronic textiles and wearable technology in Berlin.
Yeah, and it's called Koba.
And it is open for 1 year. And we're a real tailor shop taking orders from customers who somehow find out about us. Maybe walk by, come in, mm-hmm. find out about what we can do with technology and clothing, and come up with ideas and place their orders.
Mm-hmm. So that's how Koba works.
Yep.
Yeah.
And next question, tell me about some of the most interesting commissions we've received.
Mm-hmm. Which one? challenging one maybe is the gloves, I think. One of the challenging mm-hmm. ones. Yeah.
Yeah, maybe the two of the longest going are a pair of gloves for a programmer who has been thinking about this idea for quite some time. He wants to be able to move his fingers as least as possible, using up and down movements to be able to input the whole range of the keyboard.
So the whole keyboard has to be mapped in this very small movement. And our challenge is to come up with something that would be sensitive enough to capture this small movement, this textile or textile-based interface. And and then another thing is to get a right fit for him, because gloves are quite difficult to fit.
Mm-hmm. And another challenging piece, and interesting, is Sebastian's jacket, mm-hmm. which is based off a pattern from his favorite jacket for going out. And we've replicated this and divided it into polygons. And each edge of the polygon is a fiber optic that we can illuminate with an LED. And then he's a programmer also himself, and he will have full control to be able to animate his jacket. And laying out the circuit through these polygons in the seams and designing custom circuit boards to sit on the intersections of these seams is taking us months.
Yeah. Yeah, and of course the challenge is that all this circuit has to be small enough or like flat enough so that you don't feel that you're wearing such a kind of electronics, but still it has to function well.
Yeah, and maybe in contrast, a commission that we did in a few days only, because it was based off an example that we had in the shop, mm. was a girl came by and ordered a gift for her boyfriend for his birthday, because he's into noise music.
Yeah, and then we had an example of EMF listener, so EMF electromagnetic field listener, and she liked it very much, and she was sure that he would like it. So we implemented that, like a basic circuit that we implemented before, into the pullover hoodie that she brought in, and it was really nice to see him visiting us. Didn't know what he's going to get, and was very excited to listen to the electromagnetic field.
Yeah, and we document these stories of all the commissions we receive, the people who commission them, and the process of actually making the technology work. If you go to our website, there's a category for the commissions, and you can see these stories.
Yeah, there. And this kind of feeds into this next question. What are the immediate contributions of technology to textiles? So okay, maybe that doesn't fit in. And so there's a contribution in general that we make.
No, but that's okay. We can also talk about that.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. Let's talk about that.
So our shop is about making things for real people who really would like to have these things, and there wouldn't otherwise necessarily be a place they could go. But we're also, on a bigger, or like maybe zooming out a bit, interested in proposing this as an alternative model to how we can think about technology and what we want.
Yeah, so if, like, I feel a bit like that currently technology is often perceived by us, including myself, like something that is developed somewhere, and then you see the newest blah blah blah, and then you decide if I want to have it or not, or which model do I want to have. But I hardly get to say like I want to have this, or my idea to, like, my idea being developed in some way that is something that everyone uses or not use, but something that is implemented. And we thought, okay, what if everyone could say something about what each person wants to have, and then what different technology we start to see, or should all the technology be the same, or we have so many different kind of technologies, like different types of clothing items we have or we used to have.
Mm-hmm. And then maybe this question of how it is really intended is, what are the contributions of technology to textiles? Maybe there we should also zoom out a bit and say these two things have always been so closely connected. Mm. Like one of the earliest technologies humans invented for themselves were textiles, mm, and ways of making them. So I find that a bit, if it's a particularly digital technology offers to textiles, then maybe that's what our shop is an experiment in. Like, mm, what do people want digital textiles to do for them?
Mm-hmm. And then on the other hand, we can also ask this question, what textiles can contribute to technology? And maybe, I mean, immediately when we are working with these electronics textiles, we are using a lot of textile techniques in technology, so that's one thing. But also how one works with technology. So using a textile technique and textile materials allows us to make the technology visible, and then also you can think about so many different aesthetics and where you interact with them. So it opens up the possibility of technology.
Mm-hmm. And I would also say it brings in people who would maybe not normally be involved, and traditions and cultures of textile. Mm-hmm. Next question. Mm-hmm. What's the hardest part of working with technology and textile crafts? Well, there's on the functional kind of level of craftsmanship engineering is you have hard and soft things coming together, and it's all movable and flexible. So things, electrical connections breaking, is one of the biggest, mm-hmm, things.
Yeah, and then also there is not like already very proven method or component. So a lot of components we are inventing or like make. Every time we have to make, for example, sensor, we are thinking of how can you make one and how can you connect this to this other component and so on. So, and then we don't know if they're going to last long, if it's going to break, and all these are experimental still. So that's a nice challenge, but it could be also a hard part.
Yeah, and maybe on another level, a hard thing about it is, so one solution to this hard-soft problem is to make everything as soft as possible. So to really integrate conductive fibers with the cotton and the polyester. And then a hard thing is, so what happens with this at kind of more the end of life of the use? Mm. So now you've created a material that, if you want to recycle it, very hard to separate.
Yeah.
What is the strength of Koba?
Strengths of Koba?
I think one thing is that we actually have a shop and a street in Berlin that people can see. They can look through the window and see us making. It doesn't matter if people order something or not. The fact that they can kind of understand how some of these technologies are made, I think, is a strength by just showing off our process and being a local business.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and then also maybe if you see it as an artistic project or intervention, oftentimes this, like, okay, maybe not now anymore, but when you make it in a studio and then show it in an exhibition or in a certain context, you reach audience that is already prepared to see, you know, artistic work, or maybe you don't reach everyone, but just being in the shop front for a longer time on the normal streets, you reach different types of people, and then also you make yourself visible, and that's maybe also a strength of this project.
What is our contribution to society?
Ah, so that came.
Yeah, I think with the Korba project in particular, it's this proposing an alternative way of doing things and involving people in this proposal.
Then and then also bringing people into discussion too. Like us being here and then proposing this thing, a lot of people comes in with curiosity and they say like, aha, I understand, but, and then they start to question like, what is the economic system? Is this sustainable? Or what do I want to have? Okay, do I never question about technology? So a lot of questions comes and then kind of starts to have some kind of discussion or maybe thought process in a lot of people. And that could be a contribution, or I see that as a contribution.
The discussion. And having a platform here, a space that we can use for public discussion. And where do we see Korba Kant or Korba in 5 years or more? So the shop will close in half a year, in January 2019, and we will document what happened. And yeah, I think at this point we don't know exactly how. It will definitely feed into our future work.
Yeah, but our aim is not to continue, like, try to sustain Korba for 5 years, 10 years. But it was an experiment, and then maybe we decide to do it longer. But I think in 5 years we'll be somewhere in 5 year step, like forward step point, including maybe we are doing this again.
So yeah, if you really want to know, then I guess the only way to find out would be to
follow us.
we are only on Twitter or on our website or on Flickr and Diaspora. Thank you for these questions.
Yeah, and looking forward to hear your article.
Yes.
Read your article. In Spanish.
Yes.